Hi guys, this is Vincent, and in this video tutorial I'm going to use Capture One to do some HDR photography using the Photomatix plugin. So here I have three bracketed photos of Machu Picchu. So Machu Picchu, this is the whole area, but here's the main ruins or temples right here. And this image is the normal exposure. This one is the minus one stop, and this one is the plus one stop. So going back to the normal exposure, you can see the image, or actually all the images, it's a little bit washed out or a little bit hazy, especially in the background, and the clouds, they're a little bit overblown. And what I'm going to do is merge or tone map these images in Photomatix. One thing you'll notice in Photomatix is just due to this image being blown out or hazy, it's not going to come out that good, but I'm going to do a little bit of selective adjustments to just make sure or make this area of the temples pop. So I'm going to start off with selecting all of these three photos. So I'm just going to shift click right here and they're all selected. And now I'm going to go to edit with and merge to HDR with Photomatix Pro. And I'll just leave it at JPEG for the format. And the file name will just combine all the raw file names right here, which is 5584, 85, and 86. So I'll click on this, edit variants. And what will happen is Photomatix will pop up and it'll give me some merge options. So it'll align the source images, so I'll make sure that's selected, and include perspective correction. I'll leave that off. I believe this was taken on a tripod, and I'll have the option to show options to remove ghosts clicked, and I'll reduce noise on all images. And I don't think there's any chromatic aberration in this photo when I already looked at it before. So I'll just go ahead and click on Align and Show Deghosting. So I'll just take a few seconds for Capture One Pro to export the three images into Photomatix. Okay, so now I have the deghosting option. So with the deghosting options, the main thing that's going to be moving or that might be moving are the clouds. So I'm just going to leave it on automatic deghosting and just leave it on mild. And I'll select the negative exposure as the main or base photo to do the ghosting option. And I'll click OK. Okay, so now I have the HDR tone mapped image in Photomatix. So you can see the image doesn't look too great here, and I'll just take a look and look at some of the presets, and they're not that amazing just because the image is mainly blown out or washed out with the haze. It was also a foggy in the morning before I took this photo, so there could be quite a bit of humidity. And due to the image not being that great, I'm not going to bother with the adjustments here. I already played around with it before, and it doesn't make too much of an improvement. What I'll do is I will select this photographic preset in Photomatix and click Finish. And I'm not going to sharpen or anything like that, so I'll just save and re-import. And now I have the image in Photomatix. The image in Capture One Pro. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do some editing to this merged image. The main thing I want to first do is reduce the highlights in the clouds. And how I'm going to do that is I'm going to select an empty layer by clicking here. And then I'm going to click the gradient option right here. I'm just going to down drag it I'm going to make the gradient a little bit smaller and drag it down right here. And I'm going to go to the brightness and reduce the brightness to reveal a little bit more of the clouds. And I'll test out the highlight as well. See if that makes a difference. No, it doesn't. And the whites, no. So I think brightness is the best option by just decreasing it. And one thing I need to do as well now is crop the photo because this is the main subject here. So I don't need too much of the sky or the top portion. So I'll just click here and right click. I'll leave the ratio on 16:9, which is standard size. Okay, I'll just press enter. Okay, now the image looks a lot better here. What I also want to do is put a little bit more focus on this area here. So I'm going to create another layer. I'm going to select the radial gradient mask. And I'm just going to create a mask over the ruins here. And now I'm going to decrease the exposure a little bit. Just slightly. Actually a little bit more. And I'm also going to make this area, the shadows, a little bit darker. And that'll emphasize the middle part right here. And I'm also going to create another layer and I'm going to duplicate it. Press the plus sign here. And then copy mask from layer 2. And I'm going to invert the mask. So now the mask should be just adjusting this. So I'm going to go to the tone curve or the RGB curve and increase the brightness of the midtones a little bit. And I'm going to make this mask a little bit bigger. And also make the feathering a little bit bigger. So let's take a look at it now. So it's a little bit too bright, the center, so I'm going to go back to the layer 2, which controls a lot of the shadows. And I'm going to increase the shadows a little bit, just to make it look a little bit better. And I'm going to go back to layer 3, and I also have to add a little bit of sharpening here. So I'm going to go click on the details here. I'm going to press Z or Z to zoom in and sharpen this image just slightly, or at least the center part. Okay, that looks good. I'm going to reduce the sharpening a little bit. Okay, that looks a lot better. And going back to the background or the overall image, I do need to add a little bit of color. And that is, where is that again? Right here, the saturation is. So add a little bit of saturation to the overall look of the image. I'm also going to add a little bit of clarity. I'm going to bump it up all the way to 100 to see how it looks. And actually, I will keep it at 30, no, actually 25. and I'm going to add a little bit of structure. And I find the method of natural looks best compared to punch, neutral, or classic, so I'll just keep it at natural. And let's take a look at the before and after image of this. So the image does look a lot better, and the overall image still looks a little bit dark. So I'm going to just stay on the background and just slightly increase the midtones to brighten up the overall image. And that looks good. And we'll take a look at the levels. Give it a slight brightness or increase the levels. And that looks good. Let me see how it looks without the levels curved. Not much of a difference. And actually, I do want to go back to layer 2 here, just to control the shadows. I want to make it a little bit darker. And there you go. So this is my final image for now. Obviously, you can make a lot more micro adjustments or play around with it. You can vignette this part here that doesn't look too good. But pretty much, it's just to show you how to use Photomatix Pro, the plugin, and do a little bit of HDR editing after in Capture One Pro. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Have a good one.